Hello everyone, this is Harsh and you are watching WPI World. In this video we will learn how to filter the data grid. I want to filter the data grid based on the text box text change. Now I will add one tool to the grid and I will update the other control like data grid row H1 and the grid row H2. And for the first row I will add text box. Here I will point the text box text property. So let's change the width of text box to 150 and height is 30. Now update the row thickness line to 40. Now I will try to change the horizontal element to left. So now it will look good. Now I want to add the property to view model. For that we need to type profile and tab. It will add the property and I will change the data type into string here and update the property name text to filter. And add the on property change to the setter and update this value. Filter the data grid, we need iCollectionView, so we'll add the property of type iCollectionView. Add the property type profile and tab, it will add the property and I will update, I will modify into iCollectionView and change the name to employee collection and update the property to employee collection. Now let's initialize employee collection inside the constructor. Here we have to initialize the employee collection equal to we have to use collection view source to initialize that employee collection. Inside collection view source we have one method called getDefaultView, and getDefaultView we have to pass the observable collection which is in the list of employee. The list employee detail we have to pass. Now we can run the project and we can test the result. Let's run it. If you can see, all things are pointed properly. Now we will add the filter, and I want to filter by the employee name, so I will create a method for filter by name and I will add the definition inside that method. I will update that parameter to emp, and first we need to parse it to employee detail, like we will initialize employee detail to emp as employee detail. And I will add the logic for filtering the employee detail. So first we have to check the employee detail of the null, and we have to check employee detail name if contain that the box text which will be pointed to text to filter property. If it contain the text to filter property, so it will show the to the data grid. Okay, now let's run it. Yeah, it's through the exception because here text to filter is null, so to fix it we have to check for null and empty. Here we will check for null and empty for the text to filter property, and if it is null or empty then we will not do the any logic inside that, we will simply return the true. Let's run and see the result. Here we will type the into the text box. It's nothing happening here. Here I have to add the upgrade source trigger to property chain because we want to update the data grid based on the property chain, but it's nothing happened here. So what I need wrong? Okay, I have to move that filter to the setter of the text to filter property. Now let's run and check the result. Okay, now I'm typing the name. See, it's not matching with the name column, so it is not showing anything. You can see here Kumar is present in name column, so it is showing all the result of the Kumar. Now you can see here there is no space between hyper and one. Now I will try to keep the space and type the 12, so it will display the employee name with Kumar hyper space 12. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you think this video helped you, let's share it.